Beginning to understand. Some of the statues were the representation of power, perfection, and strength, applied to the other type of sculptures that probably represented his victims. It was him, crushing his ego against his models, forcing them to mold his works, die instantly, and become part of his art forever. I had discovered that those sculptures weren't simple exhibitions, and that I was in danger. I was indirectly represented by the victims, something that I immediately hated for the position it put me in. But I had to identify with them, to survive, and to get him. Thank you. I had reached the sculptor's chambers. I couldn't believe that he saw himself that way. But this place was governed by his rules, so I had to accept and try to survive at all costs. I had to make him pay for his crimes and avenge each of his victims. But I was closer to becoming one of them. His presence was imposing and intimidating, but the power of his own ego was so great that it would end up crumbling the pillars of his conscience. I exhaled a sigh of relief, knowing that I wasn't there when it happened. Bit by bit, the horror is consumed, as if moving into a vortex along with those sculptures. Reality is compressed at the sight of those vanity devices cracking and shattering. My hands, covered in clay, make a way out of that place. In just an instant, the only thing left is the void. An incomprehensible feeling of peace. Feeling of justice. Something happened at first with the professor, and it just happened again with the sculptor. When searching the dungeons that form his mind, that discordant sensation appeared inside of me. It was something unknown, revolting, but for some reason, familiar to me. These horrors, when discovered by the darkness veil, resound in me like echoes from the past, as if all this had already happened before. one of the abnormalities I've encountered so far have served as examples of the rotten nature of existence. Like a hound chasing its prey, that rottenness calls me out, begging to be cleared. Like a mistake waiting to be mended.